नमस्कार, माय सेल्फ डॉक्टर दीप्ति बिष्ट, प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ गाय चिकित्सा, फैकल्टी ऑफ आयुर्वेद साइंसेज, ज्योति विद्यापीठ, वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर. इन टुडे सेशन फॉर क्लास 4 बीएमएससी 4th ईयर वी आर गोइंग टू टेक द टॉपिक कंजेस्टिव हार्ट फेलियर, ऑल्सो नोन एज कंजेस्टिव कार्डियक फेलियर. सो लेट्स बिगिन द लेक्चर और टॉपिक विद इंट्रोडक्शन. When heart is not able to function properly, it can result in either peripheral circulatory failure or condition of shock or congestive cardiac failure, thereby meaning that there is congestion in some part of the circulation. If it's primarily the left ventricle that fails, the congestion develops in the pulmonary circulation and may lead to pulmonary edema. On other hand, if it is the right ventricle that fails primarily, then the congestion develops in the systemic circulation. Now, the compensatory mechanisms in congestive cardiac failure. While heart is not able to maintain adequate output, the body tries to maintain by other means. And these means are, first, the activation of renin-angiotensin-aldosterone mechanism. It results in conservation of salt and water, thus increasing the blood volume and trying to maintain blood pressure. Similarly, sympathetic stimulation of heart increases heart rate, and then heart starts pumping faster than normal. However, sometimes the effect of these compensatory mechanisms is counterproductive. While increasing blood volume leads to peripheral edema and weight gain, it may add to the exertion of the heart. Pulmonary congestion reduces oxygenation of the blood and the heart suffers from ischemia, thus its performance further deteriorates. Left ventricular failure. The causes of left ventricular failure are of two types. Either there is normal or low output failure. The causes are hypertension, aortic stenosis, coarctation of aorta, aortic regurgitation, mitral regurgitation, angina, infarction, or cardiomyopathy. In this condition, heart is not able to pump or to produce the required output, so these are low output left ventricular failure. Another is high output failure, where amount of blood pumped is more than typical and heart is unable to keep up. This can occur in overload situations, like in cases of blood or serum infusion, kidney diseases, chronic severe anemia, beriberi, which is due to vitamin B1 deficiency, in conditions like cirrhosis and thyrotoxicosis. So in high output ventricular failure, amount of blood is more than typical, yet heart is unable to keep it up. Now clinical features. If we see the clinical features of left ventricular failure, symptoms which are usually encountered are exertional dyspnea, paroxysmal nocturnal dyspnea, autonia. Even cough and lying down may be due to left ventricular failure. Some patients may have weakness and fatigue. In severe pulmonary edema, there may be pink for the expectoration. Signs are tachycardia due to increased heart rate, gallop rhythm may be there, bilateral basal crepitations. Some patients may have hydrothorax, that is pleural effusion, in which fluid contains low protein, that is it is transient in nature. There may be pallor and cold extremities due to a variable proportion of periphery circulatory failure. Now, right ventricular failure. causes are pulmonary congestion due to left ventricular failure leads to reflex pulmonary vasoconstriction, and this is the most common cause of right ventricular failure. Other causes are poor pulmonary stenosis, atrial septal defect, tricuspid stenosis, tricuspid regurgitation, and right ventricular infarct. Clinical features which are seen, symptoms include pain in abdomen, mainly right hypochondric region due to congested liver. There is anorexia, nausea, and vomiting. Swelling is usually seen over feet or back when patient is in lying position. Signs are full neck pain, hepatomegaly, pedal edema. So both pictures of left ventricular failure and right ventricular failure when combined in the same patient, then the resultant is congestive cardiac failure. There are some precipitating or aggravating factors which usually induce an acute case of congestive cardiac failure. These are fever, respiratory infection, cardiac arrhythmia, physical and emotional stress, intravenous fluid or blood effusion, increased salt intake. Investigations which are usually done, complete blood count. Other blood tests include test for electrolytes, renal function test, liver function test, thyroid function test, and often C-reactive protein test is done if any kind of infection is suspected. Then another test, BNP, that is brain natriuretic peptide, is done, which is a specific test of heart failure indication. Routine and microscopic urine examination is done. X-ray check is done to exclude any other causes of lung infection, and usually in cases of heart failure, cardiomegaly is seen. ECG is done to identify arrhythmias, ischemic heart disease, right and left ventricular hypertrophy, and presence of conduction delay or abnormality like left bundle branch block. Echocardiography is very important investigation. It is of two types, 2D echo and another is color Doppler. Then angiography, which is an invasive investigation, is sometimes done. It is the X-ray imaging of blood vessels, which is done by injecting contrast agent into the bloodstream through a catheter, which is placed directly in the blood vessel. X-ray images obtained are called angiograms. Heart failure may be the result of coronary artery disease, and its prognosis depends in part on the ability of the coronary artery to supply blood to the heart muscle. As a result, coronary catheterization may be used to identify possibilities for revascularization through percutaneous coronary intervention or bypass surgery. The importance of echocardiography. Why it is valuable? It provides information like size of various chambers, that is ventricles and atrium, opening and closing of wall leaflet, if there is any calcification of walls, any vegetation, wall motion abnormality, that is which wall is not functioning normally, this all can be seen. Besides this, ejection fraction is also calculated. If left ventricular ejection fraction is less than 28%, it indicates severity. Now, staging of congestive cardiac heart failure is done by American College of Cardiology or American Heart Association. It includes four stages of heart failure. Stage A, In this stage, people at high risk for developing heart failure in the future, but they have no functional or structural heart disorders. Stage B includes those conditions when there is a structural heart disorder present, but no symptoms at any stage. Stage C includes those persons where previous or current symptoms of heart failure in the context of an underlying structural heart problem is there, but it can be managed with medical treatment. Stage D includes advanced disease conditions requiring hospital-based support, a heart transplant, or palliative care. Now, management. Management of PCR focuses on improving the symptoms and preventing the progression of disease. Reversible causes of heart failure also need to be addressed. For example, infection, alcohol ingestion, anemia, thyrotoxicosis, arrhythmia, and hypertension. Treatments include lifestyle and pharmacological modalities, occasionally various forms of device therapy, and rarely cardiac transplantation. Now, the management protocol of acute decompensated heart or acute condition where CCF is precipitated by some underlying cause and patient is in emergency condition. Here, the immediate goal is to re-establish adequate perfusion and oxygen delivery to an organ, that is, ensuring the airway, breathing, and circulation. Immediate treatment usually involves some combination of vasodilators such as nitroglycerin, diuretics such as furosemide, and possibly non-invasive positive pressure ventilation. Supplemental oxygen is indicated in those who have oxygen saturation levels below 90%. In cases of non-decompensated CCF, that is chronic management, the goals of treatment are prolongation of life, prevention of acute decompensation, and reduction of symptoms, allowing for greater activity. Since heart failure can result from a variety of conditions like thyroid disease, anemia, chronic tachycardia, alcohol use disorder, hypertension, dysfunctions of one or more heart valves, so all these conditions should be treated first. Then behavioral, medical, and device treatment strategies exist that can provide a significant improvement in persons falling under different stages, and they include relief of symptoms, exercise tolerance, and a decrease in likelihood of hospitalization or death. Similarly, in cases of person having chronic obstructive pulmonary disease and heart failure, breathless rehabilitation is done with exercise training. Iron supplementation is done for person having iron deficiency anemia and resulting heart failure. Behavior modification is a primary consideration in chronic heart failure management program with dietary guidelines regarding fluid and salt intake. Food restriction is important to reduce food retention in the body and to correct hyponatremic status of the body. Exercise should be encouraged and should be modified to suit individual capabilities. Similarly, regular monitoring at heart failure clinic reduces the need of hospitalization and improves life expectancy. Now, medications which are usually used, these are digoxin, nitrate, diuretics or ACE inhibitors, antihypertensive. Then, digoxin and amiron, which increase the contractile power of heart, beta blockers, which are used to reduce metabolic demand, and surgical interventions in cases of valvular disease. Now, ACE inhibitors usually open up the narrowed blood vessels to improve blood flow, and they should not be taken with the following medications like thiazide diuretic, potassium sparing diuretic, and non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. These are some contraindications. Beta blockers usually decrease the work the heart has to do and can reduce blood pressure and flow of rapid heart rhythm, but they should be taken with caution with the medicines like antiarrhythmic medications, Antihypertensive medications like lisinopril, candesartan, amlodipine, and antipsychotic drugs like cyclodextrin. Diuretics are used to reduce body fluid content because CHF can cause body to retain more fluid and then it should be used. Loop diuretics, potassium sparing diuretics, and thiazide diuretics are three groups of diuretics which are used according to situation of patient. Prognosis and CCF. In cases of chronic congestive cardiac failure, prognosis is good. Here, very small dose of ACE inhibitors and diuretics with digoxins are required to maintain patient health. In cases of acute CCF, prognosis is bad and the cases should be treated in hospital and should be treated as emergency conditions. So this was all about congestive heart failure. In next lecture, we will cover some other topics. Namaskar. Have a nice day.